The Philippines' largest power distributor, Meralco, assures the public it has secured enough power supply to meet the demands of its customers despite the recent brownouts in Luzon. But Meralco CEO Ray Espinosa admits its operations can still be affected whenever the Luzon grid experiences yellow and red alerts. That's why he's urging the government to rethink its policies in power supply contracts and to build new power plants to prevent any more blackouts, especially as demand returns to pre-pandemic levels. For more on this, we're now joined by Joe Zaldarriaga, Meralco's Vice President and Head of Corporate Communications. Filipinos are used to the precarious power situation in the country. What efforts have Meralco been doing to at least ease the impact of the power situation to its consumers?
First and foremost, the commitment of Meralco is that we will work 24/7 to keep your lights on. Having said that, however, we have no control over supply. Rest assured, though, that we continue to work with the rest of the energy sector as we closely monitor the power supply situation on a daily basis. And in case of red or yellow alerts, we also have made the necessary preparations on the distribution and demand side management as we continue to assure our customers that as long as there is enough supply, then there will be no issue insofar as our system capability is concerned. As you know, rotating brownouts are mainly due to insufficient operating reserves brought about by unplanned power plant outages. And the red and yellow alert basically means insufficient supply in the grid. And because of this, there are instances like in the past month of May 31st and on June 1, when we had to implement what is called the manual load dropping or rotating brownout schedule. It is used at times as a measure to manage the supply deficiency.
Mm-hmm. I'm just curious, how is power demand? You know, we're in the middle of a pandemic. Is it actually lower still versus pre-pandemic level, or it's actually the same?
Yeah. Well, actually, in May, we already breached the pre-pandemic levels as the grid went up by more than 11,000 megawatts. I can give you the actual figures later. We see that slowly the economy is starting to return in terms of activity to pre-pandemic levels, albeit very, very slowly. But compared to last year, 2020, where demand was much, much lower, we're seeing an uptick in power usage in our franchise area.
Is it weather-related? Probably because of the warm weather.
The summer months that we experienced this year was quite warm.
Unusually hot, right?
The temperature was unusually hot, as you mentioned, and that drove demand. And plus, as I said, I think the economy is starting to pick up as frictions are easing up as well. And people have learned to really do their activity at home. So that also drove demand in the residential sector.
So aside from distribution, Meralco has entered into power generation. Can this help with the country's energy requirements?
Just last month, actually, the 50 megawatts solar power plant of Power Source First Bulacan Solar had officially started commercial operation and now provides clean and renewable power to the Luzon grid. This plant is located in San Miguel, Bulacan, and this project is a joint undertaking of MGEN Renewable Energy Inc., which owns 60% of the project, and Power Source Energy Holdings Corporation. MGEN is the renewable energy unit of Meralco Power Gen Corporation, which in turn is the power generation arm of Meralco. So Bulacan Sol now plays a significant role in the One Meralco Group's long-term sustainability agenda, and actually is also another step in addressing the country's need for energy, more energy, and its energy requirements. To us, I think this is a modest step into RE, but we feel is significant for Meralco. And looking to the future, we look forward to many more investments in RE, particularly solar, as we attempt to achieve the needed balance in our sourcing strategy. In July 2019, we made our commitment and announcement that we would join the shift to RE, and we will intensify in adopting sustainable practices for the One Meralco Group. And as we realized, the very first renewable power plant, the first of several that Meralco has lined up for investment and sourcing, we're actually very excited for the future of Meralco's investments in RE.
Meralco, or your company earlier, called on the government to rethink of its policies on supply contracts and the construction of new power plants. Can you expound more on this? Like, what do you mean by it?
We are part of the bigger energy supply chain, April. As you know, there are three pillars, generation, transmission, and distribution. And at the end of the day, the country and the energy sector at this point is really focusing on the need for new supply. And I mean, part of this is to look into policies and securing permits and contracts that will encourage the entry of new investments and new power plant. We feel that this would mean that policies should encourage the development and creation of this environment. Most of the existing power plants are already quite old, and some break down. Although it's not scheduled, it suddenly goes offline. So the building of new capacity, of new plants, will definitely increase power generation capability and capacity. And so from a Meralco franchise perspective, so, since we are the ones directly interfacing with customers, there is a need to have ample supply for our consumers. And having said that, the power supply situation in Luzon, although we are amply contracted, once there is a shortfall, it affects us as well because we are part of the bigger Luzon grid. And so if there is a shortfall, we have to have our share as well on the supply deficiency. So once the shortage impacts on the grid, the system operator, which is NDCP, in consultation with the government, will now tell us to undertake a manual load dropping or rotating brownout scheme. So as I mentioned, it means even if our supply contracts amply cover us, we will still have to share in the burden of reducing the supply shortage. Otherwise, there is danger if we don't do that, which may impact on grid security.
Can Meralco still afford to award more supply contracts, and that in turn will encourage more companies? You know, now that you have a supply contract, you could actually have more confidence when you build a power plant, you know?
I'm sure as you have seen in reports, we have actually undertaken several competitive selection process initiatives were awarded through a bidding supply contracts to cover our future demand. So as far as Meralco is concerned, as I said, we are covered in terms of our contracts and in terms of what we need as far as supply is concerned, both currently and moving forward as well. Because that is really part of the mandate of any distribution utility, to make sure that you have covered yourself in terms of what your power requirements are. And you need to do this through the competitive selection process so that you're able to get the least cost, cost in the most reliable manner.
Okay, what about the comments of Secretary Cusi saying that the government is looking into the nationalization of the power assets to prevent further outages in the future? I mean, what can you say about this?
Well, we will leave that to the wisdom of government, April. As I said, as far as Meralco is concerned, we continue to work with the power industry with the Department of Energy, and whatever will be best for the industry, we will defer to the wisdom of government. We are here to support government. We are here to support the entire industry.
Okay, with that, thank you very much,